Good day, academic learners! This is the GIS by Sir Sunny, where learning essentials are acquired. Last time, we talked about thesis statement. Before we start our lesson, may I ask you this? Do you think being organized is important? If your answer is yes, absolutely, you're right. In every task you do, whenever activity it is, be at home, in school, or anywhere, organization of ideas is a requirement. No matter how compelling your ideas are, this will not be appreciated by the reader if these ideas are not well organized. Readers appreciate it when they see the relationship of the information in the text. One of the common ways to achieve it is by using an outline. In this episode, our target competency is outlines reading text in various disciplines. Now, let's define outlining. Outlining is a tool we use in the writing process to help us organize our ideas, visualize our paper's potential structure, and to further flesh out and develop points. It allows the writers to understand how he or she will connect the information to support the thesis statement and the claims of the paper. We have also basic type of outlining. We have topic and sentence outline. To further understand, when we say topic outline, it is a systematic arrangement that consists of words and short phrases. It is useful when you want to arrange your ideas hierarchically to show which is the main point and which are the sub-points. Next is sentence outline. On the other hand, functions like a topic outline. However, instead of simply identifying your main and sub-points using words and short phrases, sentences are used to express specific and complex details. A formal sentence has four uses. Number one, it helps a writer to clarify his or her purpose. Number two, it offers a convenient way of testing the proposed organization of an essay. Number three, it serves as a means of communication in itself. And number four, it may be used as an aid to efficient reading. Here are some steps of outlining suggested by Chongson and Rodriguez 2016. First is read the entire text. Skim the text forward. Having an overview of the reading content will help you to follow its structure. Second is locate the main idea or the thesis of the whole essay. Look for the title of the text. Look for the heading, if any. Look for the information that answers the question, what is the text all about? Third is look for key phrases in each paragraph of the essay. Fourth is locate the topic sentence of each paragraph of the essay. Fifth is depending on the length of the text, look at the topic sentence and group those with ideas together. See if they describe a process or an example. Followed by logically organized information. The content of the reading are arranged according to levels. A level refers to the numbers of rank in the hierarchy of information in the reading. Provide the general name for each group of topic sentences. This will be the main division of your outline. Label this with Roman numerals. The topic sentence will be the subtopics. Label this with capital letters. Then evaluate the supporting details provided. This will be the third level of your outline. Label this with Arabic numerals. And lastly, go back to the text after you finished your outline. Check whether you followed its sequence closely and that you have not missed any important information. And there you have it. Just to remind you, academic learners, outlines help you to better understand the materials you are reading and allows you to better remember the things that you have read. You can even use them as your study guide. That concludes our discussion on outlining. I hope you've learned something in this video. For more videos regarding English for Academic and Professional Purposes or EAPP, give this video a thumbs up, share to your friends, and consider subscribing to be updated in all my latest videos. Bye!